No, that was just weird. That's the first time I've had that happen before. No CETA, no military, stay out. What's the scariest horror game you've played? Probably Alien Isolation and Outlast. So pretty much the two games we played on stream, I think, are probably the scariest. When I was younger, I probably would have said Resident Evil 3, but honestly, like, playing that game as an adult, it's not really as scary as I remember it. There was a couple of jump scares in there, but I don't really consider that good horror, though. Hey guys, could you save me, please?
Stop shooting me. Reloading! Reloading!
Well, I'm leaving you guys behind again.
Boomer bow here. Here comes some boomer bow!
Reloading here! Reloading!
Did one of them actually just pick up a frying pan? It's the first time I've ever seen them actually grab a melee weapon. I still remember you jumping during the Outlast 2 demo. That demo was awesome, honestly. Outlast is a good game. I had no idea what the hell was happening throughout most of it, but, like, it was pretty scary. Especially Outlast 1. Outlast 1 is just super confusing. Bro, another tank? Level 1? Where is he? Oh, he spawned behind us? You're a bitch. Thanks, coach. Holy shit, the shotgun sucks.
Pistol.
God, another campaign that's just brutal right off the bat. Oh man, she's gonna be really annoying to deal with during the event. I'm actually gonna take her out before we start the events. Okay, good. I didn't want him to, like, accidentally hit her during, like, the horde fight. There's like an ammo pile or something nearby. Or just another gun to grab. Ah, well, there's an Uzi.
Oh, the swamp's buggy. Who would have guessed that? I'm calling the ferry.
That was a defib. Alright, which way are they coming from? Probably above us. Guys, what the fuck is your issue with jockeys?
Reloading.
Christ, these guys are just trash right now.
Reloading.
I'm leaving you all behind. Oh, well, I guess I can't.
I
didn't know they could actually just cross over there. Like, I just never noticed that before.
Okay, stay on the walkway.
Girl's got the right idea.
Weapons over here!
Who needs a walkway when you got adrenaline? Holy shit, you guys literally will just ignore me every time at a jockey.
I owe you one.
I don't owe you shit. Danger, do not feed the gators.
Anyone else feel like crap right now?
Man, honestly, I wish instead of Back for Blood, we just got like a more modernized like Left 4 Dead game. Just like Left 4 Dead on like Unreal 5 or something. Be able to like aim down sights, just added like a couple of new infected and weapons and stuff. Improved like graphics.
There's a pipe bomb here. I'll snipe.
Back 4 Blood is just a poor cheap copy. Imagine Left 4 Dead 2 remastered on console with mod support. Aw, oh, that'd be so cool. Probably only for Xbox One though, because Sony doesn't like shit apparently. I really don't know what Sony's big deal about console modding is. Campaign's not as bad as I remembered.
Reload.
Hey, I can see a light.
I just don't think it was as exciting as the other games or the other campaigns.
Have to heal. This is what I'm talking about.
Although I do remember the finale for this being the plantation, and that level's actually kind of hard.
Does anyone have any... I guess this is where the drain pipe drains.
Try to cover yourself in mud.
I basically know that Back 4 Blood, though, is not gonna hold up to, like, Left 4 Dead 2 in any capacity. But I am kinda curious to, like, try it out if it ever has, like, a free weekend or something. I definitely wouldn't buy it with how, like, predatory their microtransactions are. But I at least want to try it. Just without having to pay for it.
Mama told me not to play with fire, but...
Over! Actually, though, I think you did say it was free on Game Pass, right? Because if it's free on Game Pass, I might actually get it.
Pills here. Charger. Reloading. Jackie.
I still can't believe that my stream just fucking crashed. I had no idea what that was about.
First aid kit.
Grabbing a pipe bomb.
Hunter.
Reloading. We have guns here. Oh.
The fuck was that sound effect? Well, as much as I don't like the SCAR, I do want something that's better than a sniper rifle. I need to get a weapon mod for the SCAR. Maybe then I'll actually use it more. Alright, I gotta be careful with the witch and that I don't accidentally hit her with, like, the, explosive ammo.
You think the slides will activate?
Oh, she's literally right on the other side of the fucking plane door. This is definitely also not a location I would want to piss the witch off. Oh, coach, please fucking come and save me. Coach.
I can use a hand here.
Relax.
I hate all of these fucking AIs. I swear to God. These guys are more useless than balls on a dildo. I might as well have just fought the witch. Would have just been the same outcome. Actually, yeah, I'll keep the Molotov. I have no idea if there's a tank up ahead. Another one? Who pissed the witch off? No one was even near the witch. Oh my god. These guys are so fucking dumb. Man, I know we're playing on advanced, but, like, normally would... Oh, I guess I shouldn't say that. I feel like I always say that, like, these campaigns are pretty easy, and then we end up just getting, like, every sort of, like, spawn possible. So, like, I think design-wise, I like this campaign, but I think the main issue that I'm actually having with it, playing back through it again, is there's way too much foliage. Because just, like, a lot of the times when a horde comes in, they're just, like, you just, like, can't see where they're coming from half the time. Same with, like, the special infected, like, this map is just super annoying for just, like, special infected smokers, chargers. There's just way too much, like, foliage. Although, like I said, remember, this is kind of just like, us just, like, quickly glossing through the campaigns, too. Eventually, I plan on going into, like, an in-depth analysis and doing a, like, a little tier list on all my favorite and least favorite maps. Coach has just followed me shortly behind in terms of kills. Which I'm not surprised at all. This fucking... I have been doing awful this campaign. Literally everything has just been after me. Oh, at least it finally gave me my favorite gun. Swamp people didn't make it. Looks like some of them headed off to a plantation. Don't let outsiders in. We only got food and water for us. Napoleon. Babin ran off like a coward. Jules got tired of watching everybody die. Gone to find a boat at plantation house. You're smart. You'll do the same, RR. I guess these are just people that died. They are in the water. Anyone still alive, go to the plantation house.
We should look around and see if they left supplies.
Actually, I'll be right back, guys. I need to grab a drink real quick. I'm back.
Reloading.
Yeah, this campaign isn't too bad. I do realize that I've been going hard on some of these campaigns. And that's why I want to do the, tier list. To, like, give me a moment to, like, compose myself. And then give it a more, like, in-depth thought on it. I mean, to be fair, I think I've been doing a pretty fair job at that. I've been thinking about the campaigns objectively compared to, like, what my dumb teammates are doing in this game. Another goddamn witch. Bro, you think it'd be was playing like Hard Rain right now. There has just been like an insane number of witches. What's the charger doing? No one's over there.
Watch out, charger.
There's a lot of Molotovs around here. Mud people?
I'm a reload.
Oh, smoker's in here.
Reloading.
If I remember this level correctly, I think this one's actually kind of hard. I think this is the one where we have to like trigger an electric gate on like the dock or something, and then it's just like a straight dash to the ends. One of the crescendo events. I'm pretty sure this is like one of the more harder ones.
Holy shit, that thing's right at him.
Oh, this is like a mini safe house. I think this house is probably preparing me for that exact event. Also, I can't believe I somehow missed out on that puke. Man, if only it was an ammo pile here. Because I don't want to miss out on this gun.
Healing. Cover me. Shit. Gotta quit moving so I can heal you. Stand still, or I'm gonna mess this up.
Oh, well, sorry, Nick. That was the last first aid kit. To be fair, the one that I shouldn't have healed this coach. Oh, that's not a zombie.
Look out.
I hear a tank though, and I'm extremely low on ammo. Where is he? That's what I mean, man, but those fucking bushes, you can't like see shit in them. Oh, was he not on fire? Man, I don't want to get rid of my weapon in case there's an ammo pile. Plus, it's got that sweet laser sight on it. I don't want to get rid of this gun. Well, coach, you actually learned how to press the grenade button.
Only way over is this walkway. Reloading here.
Oh, is this the one?
Reloading here.
Also, would this really be loud enough to just draw an entire horde?
Reloading
Well, I guess that one wasn't bad. Just, like, extremely close quarters, though. That was a lot of zombies just to make it past, like, three different huts, though.
Is right up here.
Huh, that was kind of a short level too. Like what, we basically just left the safe house, did that little event, and then just crossed a couple of like docks. Oh, there's one first aid kit left. Coach, you look like the lowest. As awful as you've been, Coach, I suppose I should heal you. Well, there goes giving Coach that extra healing for nothing.
Reloading.
Could throw that first aid kit down the toilet.
Reload. There's a smoker around here.
Where'd the smoker go?
Search these houses.
Search these houses. Coach, I struggle to call them a house. It's like not even any furniture in there, bro. We'll just come back and do our final stand here. This house seems pretty defendable.
Hey, I'm reloading.
All right, weapon. Let's head down this road.
There's a plantation house.
to scaffolding.
Ooh, look at all these grenades we got here.
Bile jar here.
All these bile bombs and like pipe bombs and stuff. I do remember this one's pretty brutal though. Just because this one's insanely close quarters and it's kind of a pain to fight tanks in.
Adrenaline shot here.
It's also another one of those that have just like an insane amount of like entry points for the zombies. So, honestly, I'm not too excited for this one.
Do you think someone is still out there?
Can anyone hear me? We're at the plantation house.
Oh, the AI can actually hop onto the turrets now? I didn't know that was something the, well, it's probably something from this mod, but still, that's kinda cool. Alright, but from the looks of it, when the AI is on the turret, they're practically useless, though. I don't know how that worked. I guess we're just gonna have to try to deal with it, because I don't really know, like, any better spots we could possibly defend on here. Alright, we handled that first one pretty well. Gonna grab some of these cans for some self-defense.
Reloading.
there. It's just a little bit of less ways we have to watch for now. I mean, yeah, I guess all things considered, besides Nick going down that once, we're doing pretty good. Like, honestly, haven't been getting hit too much or anything. Quit jumping out in front of me, then. Oh, that sucks. Our first aid kits are all the way down there. Where's the tank? Oh, what? There's two of them? What the fuck? Is this normal? I have never gotten two tanks on this campaign before. First aid kit here. Holy shit, bro. Nick, you better cover my ass, boy. Sorry, Nick, I'm out of here, buddy. Honestly, this couldn't have ended any better. Finally got payback on all those awful survivors.